Listen, his love and his mercy surely is in this place, and everything is going to be all right, no matter who's in the White House. As long as Jesus is Lord at your house, everything really will be all right. Hi, I'm Dr. Ray Johnson, senior pastor here in the Walk of Dominion. Our focus for the year of 2020 has been and shall continue to be hindsight, clarity and focus with insight, hindsight and foresight. And if there's ever been a time where we need the Lord's insight, hindsight and foresight, it is a time like right now with what we're walking through in our personal lives. Our memory verse for the year still, Psalms 146:8, the Lord opens the eyes of the blind. Come on. The Lord raises those who are bowed down. My shout, the Lord loves the righteous. I love that because we aren't righteous in and of ourselves, but because of our relationship with Jesus Christ, God makes us righteous and gives us the opportunity for fellowship with him. We've been walking through this series, J3, Delivered for Destiny, Jacob, Joseph, and Job. And what we've come to find out is that when God brings deliverance in our lives, he does so. Somebody put it in the comment section, type it in, for purpose, on purpose. Come on, type that in. God brings deliverance in our lives for purpose, on purpose. And we're looking at Jacob, Joseph, and Job and coming to have an understanding of how our lives are likened to theirs and theirs likened to ours. The great news is that God's bringing about deliverance in your life for purpose, on purpose. November memory verse, still Psalms 40:2. He also brought me out of a horrible pit. My shout, out of the miry clay, that which would keep you stuck, make it difficult for you to move. God brought you out of that. Set your feet and my feet upon a rock to stay. Here's the shout, and establish my steps. I hope somebody is hearing this on tonight. God wants to establish your steps, not just for the next year, but I'm prophesying early. The next decade is your decade because you're walking according to God's steps. Monday night, that's right, this Monday night, don't miss it, the second time around. My lovely bride-to-be and I talking with you again about life, love, and laughter. And we want to encourage you in this way, looking at second time around relationships, want you to measure the toxicity level. Monday night, November 9th, don't miss it. How do you measure the toxicity level in a second or third time around relationship? Shoot, a first time around relationship, given today's times that we are in, how can I measure and know whether the relationship is toxic or not, or whether I should exit stage right or left, or how to bring about change? We got something called the acid test. You don't want to miss it. Make sure you tune in, share it with a friend. And then we want you to grow in your relationship and faith with the Lord Jesus Christ, our new life class right there on the website. If you haven't been able to get in, we have Dominion On Demand. Look for the full classes labeled Dominion's New Life class. We want to help you grow in your walk, in your work, in your relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, with him as your Lord and Savior. Look for that on Dominion On Demand, our YouTube page. Check that out. And then coming up in November on the third Sunday, 22nd, if it's your first time here, meet and greet with me in our Dominionaire Zoom room. Don't want you to miss that. Make sure that you lock in to that opportunity right at 12:15 after the morning service. I'll be inside, spend some time talking with you about mission, vision, and values here in the Walk of Dominion and how you can play a part. If there's ever been a time to connect in to the body of Christ, the local church, it is now. And we'll do that virtually this coming third Sunday of this month. Don't want you to miss it. Listen, it is for real. Many people were wondering, is it really happening? Is it really taking place? Yes, it is. December 6th is our date. Ms. Kabibi and I want to invite you out to our wedding nuptials, and it'll be right there at the historic post office in the city of Hampton, 5 o'clock on the 6th in the evening. Make sure that you go to the website at www.beginagain.tv/home. That's www.beginagain.tv/home/home. Get the information. Make sure you go to the celebrations tab in order to get your RSVP. Make sure you lock it in with us. We're registered at Amazon, Target, and Bed and Bath. Want to make sure that you've got the opportunity to be a blessing. Our Cash App, BeginAgain2426. That's $BeginAgain2426. Wednesday, November 20th, big change. Wedding shower is only going to be virtual only. Information is right there on the flyer. Look for it on my Facebook page or hers. You'll be able to participate and be a part. I'm ready to get into tonight's word. How about y'all excited about what the Lord's saying? We're in the November series, Divine Patterns of Deliverance. I call it this, the Joseph Experience. For the month of November, God's got divine patterns of deliverance for us. And we're going to look at the life of Joseph and find out how God, principally through his patterns, brought him into his divine destiny and brought deliverance into his life. Come on, let's pray and talk about the process of deliverance. If there's any time, if there's ever been a time where we need God's hand of deliverance in our lives, it is now, considering the time that we are in, and certainly with our nation. I'm certain that God wants to be in charge. No matter who's in the White House, he wants to be in charge in your house. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, thank you for meeting us here tonight through this medium. Thank you, Lord, for those who are sharing tonight's word and creating watch parties even now. God, bless us. Help us to understand you principally and your patterns of deliverance in our lives and how you want to bring us in to your plans and purposes on purpose. For purpose. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, let's get into this word. Somebody said with me, amen. Listen, the God we serve is a principled pattern God. I want us to understand that tonight as we go forward in this month of November. God is not a willy-nilly, happen chance, do things by circumstance kind of God. He is a God of synchronization, syncopation, and order. Everything that he does in concert with his divine will. He does nothing by happen chance or due to circumstance. God operates the entire universe by principles and patterns and best practices. It's important for you to know that God himself has a best practice that he applies in your life when he's bringing you into his divine plan for your life. Listen, everything in the universe and created order is by sequence and design. The synchronization of the universal laws that govern time and space all operate and function in concert with each other for the preservation of life itself. They all function in concert with each other for the preservation of life itself, which is a good shouting point for us to understand and to know that God, when he brings us into his best for our lives, he does it on purpose, for purpose, and he uses principles, practices, patterns in a system that will work regardless of the respecter of persons. My God, in here, doesn't matter who you are, what your name is, what your background is, what your gender is, if you will apply the principles and patterns of God to your life, they will work and you will find yourself into the next days that will be the best days of your life. I feel preaching early. Understanding this is critically important for us as believers because we tend to view our lives, watch this, through the narrow lens of me, mine, and no one else's. We tend to think that the world evolves around us. As human beings in general, watch this, Americans in particular, and Christians specifically, we can tend to be myopic and narrow in our view. We've got to remember God is the God of the entire world. Our narrative of life can tend to be focused, focused in on us and us alone, as if the world and life evolves and revolves around us. We must remember scripture does not ascribe to this notion. God is God of all. He is God of the world. Come on, I feel preaching. He is God over Democrats, Republicans, Independents. He's God over left and right. He's God over Catholics and Protestants. He's God over atheists and agnostics. I feel preaching and my help coming on in here early tonight. God God is God of it all. He's God of black folk and white folk and Asian folk and Hispanic folk. He's God of it all. He's God over the Coptic church, and he's God over cryptocurrency. He's God over the stock market. He is God over the health systems. God is God of all, not just some, and certainly not just a few. God is in charge, and nothing is catching him by surprise. I hope somebody hearing me tonight, the God we serve is just not the God of America, important to know, or American so-called quote-unquote Christians. Whether he is acknowledged or not, he is the God of the world, the universe, and all of humanity. He is God. Beside him, there is none other, and it would behoove all of us to get on his page and stop trying to have our own pages. I hope somebody is hearing me tonight. He is the God of all. My God, help me in here. And he's got a way. He's got patterns, and he's got principles, and he's got designs whereby which the entire universe is to function, all of the created order, and his house and your house. I feel preaching this month. Come on. Psalms 24:1 makes it plain to us. Look at David on understanding the divine principle patterns. Let me make it large on the screen for you. I don't want you to misunderstand this tonight. Look at it. Concerning the King of Glory in his kingdom, David, a psalm of David, he said in Psalm 24:1, the earth, look at that, is the Lord's, come on, and all its fullness, the world and those who dwell therein. David said everything and everybody, whether they acknowledge it or not, belong to God. Help me in here, Holy Ghost. So God is sovereign. That's what I'm saying to us tonight. When he pulls you out and brings about deliverance in your life, he does so sovereignly, for purpose, on purpose, with purpose in mind. It's not by happen chance. He doesn't just stumble into things. He doesn't just make things come about. He does it with sequence and syncopation. And we've got to read the text of the scripture, understand the world that we are in, find the move of the Holy Spirit, see what principle pattern God wants to apply so that he can bring not only you out, but everybody connected to you out on your row, in your block, in your community, on your street, in your family. I hope somebody's hearing me with this tonight. God is sovereign. So listen, when we look at this scripture, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, come on, and all who dwell therein. When we say the earth, we're talking about the physical earth itself, all of its atmosphere, the earth and the atmosphere, which we would call the heavens and each realm, all of it belongs to God. When the scripture here says, and those who dwell therein, that's all of humanity. All spirits that have a body that are in this earth all belong to him, humanity itself. Here's my one for tonight, the world, the systems of humanity, whereby which human beings function for living, the earth, those, humanity, and the world. Now, here is a misnomer that we have had before. The misnomer is that God is only operating in one realm. No, God's operating in all realms. Look at this here on the screen with me when we say systems. When we say systems, he's God over the economic system, the financial system. Here's what we mean when we say world. When we mean world, we mean world systems, okay? God is God of it all. Financial, legal, political, government, educational, even the marital and family, the religious and spiritual. The misnomer is that scripture only speaks to marital and family or religious and spiritual. That is the misnomer, that God, his word, doesn't have or does not apply in regards to the economic, financial, legal, political, governing, educational, but only he's relegated to marital and family to some degree for those that will allow, and then religious and spiritual, the church. In other words, y'all Christians, y'all stay over there in the church. Don't y'all come outside of the four walls. I wonder why that is. I wonder why Acts 4 is written. They didn't want Peter to preach in Jesus' name. I wonder why that is. I think we're about to come back to some of those days again. Here we go again. Let's check this out now. Listen, scripture speaks to all of it. All of it. and gives guidance. Here's the thing. Direction and wisdom. Here's the thing. To each of them, watch it, of how to live in relationship with God. Come on. And humanity within and with use of each. My God, in here, scripture speaks to every system. It gives guidance and direction of wisdom of how each are to function and to operate with God and humanity and inside of the systems themselves. God's word speaks to each and every one of those. And we're in a season and time where what we need is a clear clarion word of how to's. To be able to operate in the time in which we are in. I hope somebody's hearing tonight. For example, John 3:16, for God so loved the world. If I'm writing this, I'm writing it from the standpoint that we teach it and preach it that God so loved people, he does. He not only loves people, but he loves the world. And not only did he give his son for people, but he gave his son, I know this is going to push you preachers, but he gave his son for the world, the systems that control people, the systems whereby which people live in. God, Jesus, gave his life for that as well, so that whoever believes in him, there's the switch, whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. God wants to overhaul the system by putting you, the person in the system, to operate it according to his design, and scripture speaks to that. Oh, my goodness, I know I'm in trouble with Enlightenment theologians. I know I'm in trouble with the separation of church and state. I know I'm in trouble with many people that think you're on some imperialistic notion. No, I am on the kingdom of God. Come on in here, Revelation 11 and 15. Till the kingdoms of this world become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, text says, and we shall reign forever where? Right here. On the earth. Got to keep moving tonight. Just wanted to give you that. When we look at the word world, here is what it means. Lean in. Come on, preachers. Lean in with me. The word world in John 3:16. This word world is not the word for human populations. It is the word for what human populations function in. It denotes systems whereby which we operate or live in. So Jesus gave his life, died, resurrected from the grave so that the world systems would then be able to function under the governance of God's system called the kingdom of God, so that all people all over the world will have direct connection with God and live in peace and tranquility on earth. How do you know? Strong's G2889, the word cosmos here, it means this, an apt or harmonious arrangement or constitution of order in terms of government. It's an ornament, decoration, or adornment. That is the arrangement of the stars, the heavenly host, as the ornament of the heavens. It is the order of how things are to function, the order of how things are to operate, the systems by how the universe and human populations are to operate within it. I got great examples. Let me just stop right here, put a period in, and do about 30 seconds of teaching. When the angel wrestled with Jacob, when he wrestled with Jacob and the breaking of day was coming, the angel said, you must let me go because it is the breaking of day. Why? Because the angels, as the sons of God, had to appear before God in the early parts of the morning of the day. Why? To give an account for what they were doing inside of the order of God's arrangement. In other words, were they following orders concerning you and I? Even Satan himself, Lucifer, the fallen one, had to appear before God. Job chapter 1 opens up with this dialogue of a conversation where Satan appears before God. God asks him, what have you been doing? He says, going back and forth in the earth, to and fro in it. And Job only worships you because you keep a protection around him. I'm paraphrasing. I'm talking about the order of arrangement of the system of how things function. Nothing happens. Nothing functions. Nothing goes in stand on its own by itself. Everything, it functions, operates, and flows by designs governed by God's, governed by the laws of heaven's universe and the universe of heaven on earth, which is to say, nothing happens by happen chance. Everything is under design and by order. It behooves us to get an alignment. I'm in 2021 too early, just for assignment purposes, but I want us to know God loves the world. He put Adam in place to function under his jurisdiction, to function under his leadership, to function under his authority, to be a reflection of who he is in the heavens, so humanity was to be on the earth. I hope somebody's getting this. So now let's go. Let's talk. Principle, pattern, and practice. We're talking deliverance. Whenever God brings deliverance in the life of a person, he does so for purpose, on purpose, by principle, pattern, and practice, and design. Here it is. Whenever human populations of people go awry of heaven's principle practice of how God has determined we should live in relationship with him, each other, and our environment, heaven raises up a deliverer that is sent to bring about deliverance so that we all come to God's order. My God in here, he let he that hath an ear hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. My God, let's go. So however, the deliverer themselves must walk through God's process. Moses, Jacob, Job, Jesus, Daniel, John the Baptist, Peter, Paul, the disciples, and yes, you and I. The process of being delivered to be of a benefit and blessing to others. We've got to walk through a process ourselves to be of a benefit and a blessing to others. All of us in some kind of pattern and process to be a blessing to deliver others. The process involves us, watch it, being free enough from the systems of the world and its thinking, values, and behaviors to become vessels. All of us, because not in the notes tonight, but John, 1 John 2:15-17, all that's in the world, now that sin has gotten a hold of it, is lust of the flesh, lust of the eye, pride of life. All of what we're seeing in the election season right now is for the control of power. Some want to control it so that they can fulfill the lust of the flesh. Some want to control it so that because of the pride of life. Some want to control it, lust of the flesh, because of the eyes of what they see, what they think it will mean for them. But it is meant for God's people and for God himself to have influence of the kingdom with his people in place to lead whereby which he has designed for them to do so. And as we go through life, we oftentimes find ourselves in bondages, in need of deliverance, because we've taken on the values and behaviors of the system of the world, and God is sending somebody just like you to your family. I'm getting ahead of myself. To your family members, to your faith community, to your community at large. He's sending you to your city. He's sending you to your state house. He's sending you to the White House. He's sending you in order to bring about a kingdom deliverance so that everybody will benefit. I hope somebody getting this. We will come to understand that as we study the life of Joseph, we will come to understand the hows and the whys of his life. Why heaven brought him the way he brought him. Why heaven took him the way he took him. In other words, you're going to see how God is taking you the way he's taking you. You're going to see how his hand is at work in your life as we go through this series of understanding the deliverance or the divine deliverance in the life of you as the believer as we look at Joseph. So here it is. Let's land the plane tonight. Keys to understanding God's principled pattern perspective. I want you to know God's not chaotic. He's not in confusion. He is not divided from himself. He doesn't have two halting or two opinions that are battling with themselves to determine which one is of him to function in the heavens or in the earth. Whenever you say chaos and confusion, that's satanic. Whenever you see competing voices vying for attention, that's satanic. God is very clear in his word. And what we're going to get is his word of how that applies in every moment of every situation of life, so that we come out of bondage and walk in divine patterns of deliverance for your life. My God, in here, come on. So here are a couple of key patterns. One, by principle, God intervenes with his agenda for his agenda, and that includes me. I'm saying that includes you. When I say his agenda, I mean his priorities, and you've got to get this down. It's not just about me. And I need us to understand that as believers, as Christians, as those of different ethnic persuasions, no matter where you're from in the world, God is about his priorities. It's a nice way of saying it's not just about you. You are fitted into his priorities, but you've got to find your place of function and the plan he has for you so that you can get on his team. I promise you, when you get on his team, there's a flow. Oh, God, I'm going to get there. His purposes. Understand that God's purposes include you. They include you. I got to say that to you again. Now, his priorities are not just about you, but his purposes include you. And his plans are for you. When you get that, there is a larger meta narrative that is at work in the universe. And you begin to look from that meta narrative down to a regional or a national narrative, down to a regional narrative, down to a local narrative, down to a communal narrative, down to the narrative of your house. God is at work. My God, in here. So his priorities, his purposes, and his plans, they are not just about you, include you, and they are for you. I want you to get that prism in your mind so that you won't have worry and have anxiety and have frustration and run through whatever the results of the election are, losing your mind, whatever the results, whatever's going on in your city or in your home, pulling your hair out, becoming undone with yourself. Calm down, settle down, anchor yourself in. There is a word from God. His priorities are for you. His purposes are for you. His plans are for you. I feel an unction coming on me right now. Lord, I just want to speak to somebody who's in panic mode because of the pandemic season, who's in panic mode because of the political construct that we are in, who's in panic mode because of the economic injustice, who's in panic mode because of the lack of equity in terms of the health system we're in, who's in panic mode. I want to tell them by the Spirit of God, calm down, relax. God's given you authority. There's a plan and a purpose and his priority for your life. Come on, let's get to the next key pattern by principle. Get this one. Whenever humanity walks away from God, he sends someone as an agent of change. And I want you to know that someone he's sending is you. The deal is, have you gotten in alignment with the will, the word, and the ways? Somebody put that in the comment section. Have I gotten in alignment with the will, the word, and the ways? See, now here's the thing. We must all walk through the process. Every last one of us are in process with God on some level. Process in our mind, process in our values, process in our thinking, process in our understanding, process in our doing. We are in process. Now watch this. We must allow the process to do its work. Joseph did not automatically become the first prince of Egypt. He went through a process to get there. And the process brought about certain deliverances in Joseph's life that he didn't even know he needed to be delivered from. My God, in here I'm getting, there are some things that are happening with the way you think, the way you understand, how you're walking about life, how you're going about doing what you're doing. You're operating under some bondages that you don't even know are bondages that have got your life in a cycle the way that it is in. And the Lord has sent me to play a role as the breaker through this series to break you out, that deliverance is going to be your portion no matter who's in the White House. My God, in here. I hope somebody is hearing this word on here on tonight. Come on, let's go. It's Bible study. We just talking. Here's another key principle about pattern. We must be willing to meet and come into the connect. We must be willing to meet and come into connection with the person of the process and the pattern. Not only must we come to understand the principles of the patterns, but we got to come into the connection with the person of the pattern. I got to say that to us. We got to come into connection with the person of the pattern. And that person is Jesus Christ. The person that you need to come in connection with while you're in process, a part of God's divine plan, applying his principle perspective and following his patterns for your life. You can't do it unless you have come into connection with the person. And the person is Jesus Christ himself, who is Lord in your life. I don't know if you know him tonight, but I've come tonight to introduce you to him, to help him, to allow him to reveal to you God's pattern, God's principles, God's plans concerning you and all of the systems you're in, so that you can live out God's design for you. If you don't know Jesus tonight in the pardoning of your sin, the Bible says there's but one mediator, one connecting point between God and man, the man Christ Jesus, the one who was born of a virgin, who lived 33 years, who gave his life as a sacrifice for you and I, so that we could be free from the vestiges of sin and the systematic thinking and value system and doing of the world, to be in relationship with God, that we could be in this environment of this world, but not of it. And I want to pray for you tonight for divine deliverance, for you to receive Jesus in your heart as your Lord and Savior. Come on, pray with me. This is me locking arms with you, hands with you right now, to say these words with me. Come on, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I'm a savior. I need a savior. Come into my heart, change me, save me from this world. Heal my mind and my heart and my thoughts. Live inside me, be Lord of my life. I repent from my sin. I believe that you, God, you raised Jesus from the dead just for me. And I receive him now. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, somebody say it with me. Amen, and amen, and amen. Listen, if you pray that prayer tonight, everything will be just fine. I need you to text the word believer to 40691. Click on the link in the message you get back. I want you to open that up, or simply go to Dominion On Demand. Look for the four videos of New Life at Dominion. That's me walking you through a process of what it means to be a Christian. Listen, giving time in the walk of Dominion, multiple ways in which you can give. If this word touched you tonight, if it blessed you, I want you to help us be a blessing to others. Still preparing for our Thanksgiving outreach, where we're going to serve with clothes and food. We want you to text 40691-DOM-GIVE, or you can give by our Cash App. Come on. His mercy and love. Walk of D-O-M-M-I-N. Want you to participate in that. Gotta tell you, everything gonna be just fine. It's yours, it's yours. Come on, rest of the November, divine patterns of deliverance. Don't you miss it. Tune in with a friend. Surely everything is gonna be all right. Yes.